So I got the string fixed. Now I need to file the bridge because that thing broke right on the bridge. So we're gonna take our guitar up here. Put it up here for the time being. Lean it on there. Just file this down in here. Might as well adjust the camera so we can see what's going on. There we go. Take the old nice fine point file right there. Pen file. Get in there as best I can. Because that thing just broke off in there somehow, some way. It's really not too bad looking at all. But we'll round it off a little bit more in case it was squared off somehow. We can actually stick the needle nose plier underneath the saddle there. It pops up a little bit. That way I can reach in there and get a little more of a round. Straighten it out right here as best we can. And examine the grime and grit. Yep, it's grimy and gritty looking. And then put it in there. And as it goes in, just straighten it out as best we can. Line the ball up parallel with the straightness of the string as best we can. That gives a good alignment so the string will stay in tune more. Okay, then we put it through and wind it up. Now we can change the camera angle. There we go. Get all this other stuff out of the way and slip my shoes off. String and string it through somewhere so it doesn't get us. Okay, we're all back in tune again. Okay, here we are, G. Things, put a crease in them at the post right there. I like to just round them off and slip them through things. Just kind of slip them through. Let's see if we can just slip it through in there so it stays in there somehow. There we go. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Okay, so Oh yeah, I was talking about melody. Getting that G, I came up with a melody. I don't go for accuracy, I go for timing. And then as I'm practicing things, then my fingers start to get memorized where they're supposed to go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Because to me, hand shifts are much more important than hitting the actual note. Getting my hand to where it's supposed to go is most important. Shift, 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 shift. Alright.
1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3.
And then when the wrist starts to hurt, you know, for practicing, because the hands are down here, bring the wrist and the guitar way up here and it alleviates the pain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, time and hand shifts. Hitting the notes comes later. We're just wanting to paint our canvas, paint a background, you know. We're just wanting to draw a vague picture of what we really want, then we can fill in all the details later on. So we were doing G5, it's that G5 arpeggio. Arpeggio pattern that's pleasant to the ear. Mm-hmm. all I did to get the pleasantries is after I finished the arpeggio, I moved up 2 frets, or a whole step, and I did the same pattern. Tree there. It's a G5 right there, or it's G3 in the key of D sharp. Exercise to do. Reason being because that's that number 3 box, G3. And when we take the box all the way up, we have this pattern, 2 bop patterns. We have the 7 bop, 7-1-2, and the 3 bop, 3-4-5. Then we have that triangle, or the what do they call it, cascading pattern. Cascading pattern. That's the number 1 inversion, is the cascading pattern, arpeggio. That's a C minor arpeggio, 3-4-5-6, so that's a C6 arpeggio. There's the number 5 box of the key of D sharp, that's that blues box. So we do our minor arpeggio there, or our number 6 arpeggio. That's the 2nd inversion. Then we have the D minor shape. That's the 6th note, the resolution tonic.